She overthinks and overanalyzes boys and overlooks good men. See, the problem is she's looking for the perfect man. So allow me to tell you now and save you some time and heartache, ladies. Please understand that you will probably never find him, because he doesn't exist. Stop living in a fairy tale, believing all that shit. See, if you were actually watching, you'd recognize how imperfect the man is, or at least the fairy tale type guy that you're demanding. Aladdin, a compulsive liar, lying about anything and everything, not to mention his criminal record. Beast, verbally abusive and violent by nature. And Prince Charming from Cinderella was only looking for a trophy wife, so you had to fit his needs versus him fit yours. So what does that say about him? Prince Philip from Sleeping Beauty likes somnophilia, which is when sexual arousal or orgasm are intruded on a sleeping person by making sexual contact with them. I mean, that's cool and all if you into that kind of thing, you know? Eric from The Little Mermaid keeps waiting on perfection even when he understands that you can't voice your thoughts. You show him with your actions, and even then he prefer a woman that does for him, but you can't. General Shang from Mulan gets utterly upset if you aren't a man. John Smith from Pocahontas, well, him and his friends will never leave your home, making quality time with your man a thing of the past. Do you see where I'm going with this? And Peter Pan, well, he keeps a girl on the side, unless you really do believe Tinkerbell catches an attitude every time she sees you, because that's just who she is. Hercules, well, he likes his car, better known as Pegasus, a lot more than he likes you. And yeah, these are the Prince Charmers you're comparing us to. I mean, you get what you ask for, right? But what I'm saying is, it's just as men, we are already fighting against these stereotypes and misconceptions that society has made you have on us. So to begin, give us a fair fight. We are willing to fight for you all. We ask in return is that you not add any fuel to the fire and comprehend that reputation is something that we heavily rely on. But let us show you that who we are now is not the same person we were back then. Us as men are prideful to the core, but when we are willing to put our heart out and pour our soul out to you, that's far more than any fairy tale you've ever watched or read has portrayed to you. Yet these are the images we portray to you. So she grows up searching for something that's non-existent. I mean, it's true. So the best advice that I could give you is that same quote my grandfather gave me too. We are perfectly imperfect, and I am just a man. It's not an excuse, but it is who we are. So, no one remember, a boy chases skirts, a guy pursues his dream, and a man seeks God. And saying that we are all the same is challenging God's creativity, and I'm not much of a gambler, but that is beyond obvious. And I would just not rather challenge those odds. Nah, I'm not saying that we're perfect, because I'll be the first one to admit that we're not. But if a fairy tale prince is what you're looking for, know that Prince Charming is who I am. Nah.